This video is sponsored by Udemy. If you have no educational background in business, finance or accounting, but still want to invest successfully, then check out Udemy course, Investing in Stocks for Big Gains. An investing course specially designed for those who have no educational background in business, accounting or finance.
Hello everyone, and welcome to my video blog. My name is Nrupin, and in this video, we will take a look on intrinsic value calculation of stocks. Now, intrinsic value is mostly associated with value investing because most value investors like to buy stock on intrinsic value or below it. Before we take a look on intrinsic value calculation, understand this. Intrinsic value is discounted price for future earnings. And since it is discounted price of future earnings, it can never be a precise number but an estimate. Keep in mind, there is no one definite way for calculating intrinsic value. Two different analysts can come up with two totally different intrinsic value for same stock, depending on what variables they are considering during their calculation. Again, there are several methods with help of which you can calculate intrinsic value. It can be calculated based on cash flow, it can be calculated based on cost of capital, and it can also be calculated based on average gain and loss in price with respect to total equity. In this video, we will take a look on calculating intrinsic value of stock based on earnings growth rate. To calculate intrinsic value with help of earnings growth rate, we assume business will keep earning at steady growth rate for next 5 to 10 years. This information is used to calculate what will be the value of business in future. Then we discount this information to current year by subtracting inflation from it. Now, how you calculate intrinsic value depends on what model of successful business you want to use for your investing process. For example, a business with expansion plan can be your model of successful business. A business with future prospect can be your model of successful business, or a cyclical business can be your model of successful business. Remember, a successful business is one which has potential to grow its earnings and assets, because these are two things due to which stock prices move higher. Either it be Benjamin Graham, Philip Fisher, Warren Buffett or Bill Miller, everyone recommended investors to invest in businesses that are under their area of competence. Now, your area of competence may include some industry specific businesses, cyclical businesses, turnaround businesses, businesses with growth plans, etc. Point here to note is that your area of competence should always decide what model of successful business you select to invest on. Personally, my area of competence are businesses with increasing net sales. I consider businesses with increasing net sales as great businesses. I understand impact of increasing net sales on business, and therefore that should be the metric that I should use to create my investing models. Therefore, no matter what investing method I use, my base model of successful business always remains businesses with increasing net sales. Now, to get stock at its intrinsic value, the stock must be falling in price. That gives us our criteria to pick right stock. So, ideologically, before we match any other number, we are supposed to look for stocks with increasing net sales but falling stock prices. Keep in mind, matching rest of the numbers without matching stock ideologically ain't going to give you right stock. Step 1 will always remain finding a stock that is ideological match. In this video, we will calculate intrinsic value for Aurobindo Pharma because it is consistently increasing its net sales but its stock prices are falling. I am creating this video on 23rd May 2018. Which means if you are watching this video near video creation date, you have time to see Aurobindo Pharma's performance with respect to our estimated intrinsic value. And if you are watching it in future, then you can see how it performed with respect to calculated estimate. Things that we need to calculate intrinsic value are earnings per share, earnings growth rate, and price to earning ratio. Now, let's take a look on what's happening in Aurobindo Pharma right now. Prices are falling down. At present, Aurobindo Pharma is trading for 574 rupees. On income statement, we can see net sales are increasing since last 5 years. Again, on balance sheet, we can see net worth is also increasing. Now we go back to income statement for profit after tax so that we can calculate earnings growth rate. Now here we calculate earning growth rate for 4 to 5 year range. So the profit after tax numbers that are important for us are the one which is at the start of range and one at the end of range. Here starting range is March 2013 and ending range is March 2018. This is our formula for EGR in which we will plug these values to get EGR. The answer we get is 0.36. To convert it into percentage, just multiply it by 100. Now we need earnings per share. On income statement, we can see earning per share is 29.16. Now we need current price and closing price of March 2018 to get PE. Keep in mind, we need closing price of March 2018 because financial year ends on month of March. Therefore, it is important price for PE calculation. Finally, we will need a relative PE. For that, we will either pick up industry average or we will see on average what was PE of stock for last 4 to 5 years. For this example, we will consider industry average, which is 30.2. Now we have all required numbers for our intrinsic value calculation. So let's move to spreadsheet where we will calculate intrinsic value. Now on this spreadsheet, we have only 4 inputs. Rest everything is calculated all by itself. Our inputs are EPS, earning growth rate, projected price to earning ratio, and current price of stock. The future EPS section calculates EPS for next 10 years. Based on EPS, future price of stocks for that year is estimated. So as per our estimate, if our pharma doesn't undergo split or bonus shares along with its EGR and PE staying same, then in 10 years, probably on March 2028, its price will reach 12,624. So 12,624 minus your buying price will be your gross profit. Now keep in mind, this is not your real profit. It is just number that will appear in profit. To know real profit, you have to adjust the value with respect to 10 years of inflation. If we remove 10 years of inflation from that value, you will get value for actual profit, which is 8,137. The formula we use to adjust profit with respect to inflation is as follows. Inflation adjusted profit equals amount needs to be adjusted divided by 1 plus inflation raised to the power of number of year passed, which in our case is 9. The value 573 that you see here is our intrinsic value for our pharma. I calculated it using this formula. The formula is very much same as previous formula. We only added EGR to inflation rate. One more thing to notice here is that we assumed that inflation rate for all those 10 years would remain same. At present, inflation rate of India is 5% and that's what we assumed in this example. Most of you might say that inflation rate fluctuates between 4 to 9. It might not be a good idea to assume 5% as inflation rate. A 7 or 8 would be much better number. To that, my response is I would have assumed inflation rate of 7 if GST wouldn't have got passed. At present, we are struggling with GST because of improper implementation, but in a year or two, I am expecting it to get fixed. Once GST gets fixed, inflation rate is most likely to get stabilized between 4 and 7. Keep in mind, it does not mean we will get goods cheaper. On contrary, most things will start becoming expensive. Whenever any new debt instrument is introduced in market, it creates some negative effects. For example, when insurance schemes came into market, they reduced interest rate that we used to get on deposits. When pension plans came into market, they killed government managed pension plans. Now health insurance is becoming popular. More and more people are taking them. Sooner or later, prices of health services will skyrocket due to it. As you might have also seen on television advertisements, now banks are offering as high as 30 million rupees as college education loans. If people start taking these education loans for studies, then after 10 to 15 years, a college degree will lose its importance in job market. This is how supply and demand works. The lower inflation rate will only appear on goods of our basic demands. Rest all for sure is going to become much expensive than those years when inflation rate wasn't that low. For now, just keep in mind why I am considering inflation rate of 5% instead of higher number. The next variable that we have here is market return rate. It is average profit that Nifty has historically delivered. Below that we can see returns section where we are supposed to add our buying price. The values in returns column show profit that you can expect if stock prices fail to move based on our calculated estimates and instead moves as per index. 1588 is your gross profit, and when adjusted with inflation, your net profit will be 975. As you can see, current price of Aurobindo Pharma is close to intrinsic value that we calculated. By buying Aurobindo Pharma now, we will be buying it on its intrinsic value. If we will buy it below this price, then we will be buying it for bargain. Now from what variable we can say that current price can be considered as cheap? Well, for that we will see earnings growth rate and PE. Here we have earning growth rate of 36% and PE of 20, which means earning growth rate is greater than PE. Since earning growth rate is greater than PE, we can say maybe 573 is cheap as per valuation goes. Keep in mind, Nifty return rate and inflation are entered in percentage format. They are not 0.36, 0.12 and 0.05. They are 36%, 12% and 5%. When earnings growth rate and PE are very close, we can say that prices are where they logically should be based on valuations. If PE starts moving above EGR, then we can say that now prices are taking little illogical turn. This is where relative PE comes into picture. In lot of cases, when PE of steadily growing businesses start moving towards relative PE, we say prices are at logical level if PE and growth rate align. So if we add relative PE here, then all numbers that we get here are our expected targets for respective years. Keep in mind, there is no guarantee you will get these expected numbers. Price can be higher or lower based on our business's future developments. For now, just keep in mind, we assume prices are where they should logically be when PE and EGR start becoming similar. And this is the time when we should start looking for exit strategy. Keep in mind, I said start looking for exit strategy. Do not exit right away. If PE can fall 50% of earning growth rate, there shouldn't be any reason to believe PE cannot become double of earning growth rate. Now, whatever you are seeing right now in front of you is based on assumption that earning growth rate will remain 36%. But let's be honest here, from nowhere 36% seems like very realistic expectation. To me, 15 or 20% is much better number to use in earning growth rate than 36%. If fundamentals fail to improve at rate of 30% and instead improve by rate of 20%, then intrinsic value that we will get in hands is 484. And this is much better value to consider as intrinsic value than 573. But just because it seems better value doesn't mean we have a better value. For our intrinsic value, we are stuck in price band of 573 and 484. Now, use of this kind of calculation for investing is good only for long-term investing, where minimum investment period should be 5 to 10 years. All variables that were used to calculate intrinsic value were estimates. And based on what kind of further development happens in business, they are subject to change. As per our current estimate, intrinsic value is between 573 and 484. If we buy between these price bands, we will be buying Aurobindo Pharma on its intrinsic value. If we buy below these values, we would be buying it for bargain. Keep in mind, we have no control over businesses' further development. If something bad happens to businesses' earning potential, then all this calculation will go in gutter. Therefore, proper diversification is needed. If you want to invest in value, then have at least 10 stocks with value in your portfolio. Also keep in mind, you have to keep eye on future developments of these businesses and keep changing variables in your calculations accordingly. Personally, I think this kind of investing method is mostly good for rich investors because their purchase quantity is big, and since they invest with big amount, they need a business that have huge number of outstanding shares. It helps them buy industry leaders that still hold potential to go higher in valuations. If you are a retail investor like me who does not invest more than 10,000 to 40,000 a month, then this method of investing is not really ideal for you. It is good but not ideal. Personally, I believe retail investors should go for growth investing or trend riding kind of investing. Anyways, I will try to recreate my open document spreadsheet on Google Docs. As it gets ready, I will add link in description. You can download it for your personal use. Finally, if you want to really learn something from this video, then start keeping eyes on Aurob Pharma's future performance and developments. Try to track its performance based on how we calculated intrinsic value and potential targets for it. For now, since Aurob Pharma's price has come to my calculated estimate, I will start working on my buying strategy. With that said, thanks for watching this video and have a nice day.